So, we're here. We just butchered a pig, and I'm showing a little bit about how I'm processing it. So you can see, this is the side. It's been cut along the spine, so this is one side here. And this is the other side. I've gone ahead and I've cut the skin and the layer of fat. You can see here, there's this layer of fat right here. So I took that off along this whole side, and I'm cutting it. So here's a piece of the sheet. I'm cutting it into these cubes to render it. You can come over here and see. I have this crock pot. It's kind of dark, but you can see the crock pot. It's got these little cubes in it. So I won't add any water to this. I'll just turn the crock pot on once it's full of these little pieces with the skin on it. And those will render down. It'll all melt and become kind of a different consistency, and the skin will like fry. And that'll become like pork rinds sort of thing, little fried pieces of flesh. There's also, you know, little bits of flesh in there. So, yep, that'll be all good. So what I basically did with this pig, if you can imagine, there's a whole pig here, and the head was over here. I went ahead and I cut the head off right at the first joint, and, you know, grotesquely, there's head right there. And that can be boiled and made head cheese. That's a whole other story. I then cut right at the shoulder, so the head would be over here, and there's the front legs and the shoulder. So I cut them off before I cut it in half. So this is what this is. You can see, maybe, it's that whole shoulder part with the couple of front ribs. So it's cut, you know, right there. And so what I'm going to do, I took the fat off, right? So I have pork ribs, essentially. I'll cut those ribs right there, and then I'll have ribs. I'll cut them down so they fit in the freezer easy, and then I will cut the ham like right here, so I'll have the back leg and the ham. Probably with the saw I'll cut it diagonally so that I don't have a piece of spine in there. I'll just have the leg, and that can be cut open then and the bone taken out. It's called butterflying. You like cut it open and you splay it out. Because it's got most of the fat taken off, it's not super fatty, which is nice. And then we can use that lard for cooking and stuff in other times. Then I also have the flanks here, which is kind of like what bacon is made out of. I'm not really processing this for bacon, per se, because the pigs are so small, there's like hardly any meat there, any belly meat. So I'll just cut this into stew meat, all this stuff in here, and all this stuff along the spine. And then we'll boil the spine up, make bone broth with it. You can see tomorrow, Opalyn's going to be making some beans and ham. I'm just helping her out. And putting this as the hock. You can see the little front part of the leg. So that's going to be boiled with pieces of spine and the other bottom parts of the legs in order to provide meat and fat, which are going to go with these beans, which are boiling in here. These are just red beans. So that provides a nice base. The meat provides a nice base for that kind of meal. It's a good way to get rid of those like odds and end pieces and like get the meat and stuff off of the spine and other bones that you don't want to really put in the freezer. So yeah, that's kind of like some general things that we're doing with these American guinea hogs. It's our first year butchering, and so we're trying to figure out how is a good way within the community to process the meat in ways that we'll use it and that allow us to use just little bits of meat in meals and not have, you know, meat-centric diet. And also to be able to use this good fat for cooking to replace things like vegetable oil or olive oil. So that's kind of what we're working with right now.